Now, years ago, the word got to become what? Alive in your heart. You got to consistently what? And I don't know of any piece of material that will benefit, could benefit you more than a meditation book, because we're dealing with what? Areas of need and provisions and blessings all over the Bible. Almost every need. Healing, we got 20 or 30 pages on healing and long life. In the meditation book. It's all categorized. Long life. Long life. Here is what you say. Here is what God promises. Okay, am I telling you the truth?
Man, that's always nice, but I don't think you ever.
All right. Okay, now, I can't go over all of these, but these are scriptures that you have to go over and sort through and determine which of these really register with you. Hebrews 13:15, I'm not sure what this is here. This is the next section. Okay, Romans 10, verses 8 through 9. The word is nigh thee, even in thy mouth and in thine heart, the word of faith which we preach, that if thou shalt what? Confess with the mouth the Lord Jesus, and shall what? Believe in thine heart that what? God raised him. Thou shalt be what? For with the heart, man what? Okay, that means that a person has to believe. That means you have to receive information. See, belief comes from an accumulation of what? Knowledge. You hear the gospel preached and taught, then you begin to what? Receive it, and that creates what? Belief. But belief is not enough to save you. You got to believe it in your heart, and you got to do what? Confess it with your what? Mouth. Because there's a lot of the Pharisees believed on Jesus, but they were afraid to confess him with their mouth. So you got to believe it, and you got to what? Confess it with your mouth. All right, now, my favorite portion, praise God for what you're believing for. Praise God for what you're believing for. This is the next section. And actually, we should have started with that at the beginning of the session, but since many of you weren't here on the last time, I thought I would just go over and touch upon some of those scriptures, because these are some of the most important scriptures in the Bible that pertains to our faith, the ones that we have just read. But now, we are praising God for what you're believing for. All right, now praising God for what you're believing for is, y'all remember in the Old Testament, whenever, like Jehoshaphat, when they were confronted on both sides by the enemy, and it seems like they would be totally, what, wiped out and destroyed, Jehoshaphat called the people together in 2 Chronicles 20:20. Okay, I want you to turn there just for a moment. And you'll see that how Jehoshaphat called the people to fasting and prayer. And that's important too, because the people get distracted and you really want them to regain their spiritual perspective and really get back on track. It's very important to get people to subjugate their appetites. In other words, to use some self-restraint and begin to fast and pray so that spiritual things will become a lot easier to receive. And that's the point that I was making Sunday, that Daniel's success to a large degree wasn't the only ingredient that was vital to his success. But he was a person that had a lot of self-restraint. He had control of his appetite, and as a result of that, he ate a diet that was what? That was basically what? Plant, a vegetarian. And that caused him to receive spiritual revelations a lot easier. And they were 10 times wiser and all of the other magicians and astrologers. Okay, so we see Daniel was very disciplined when it came to the control of his appetite. Okay, 2 Chronicles 20:20. 2 Chronicles 20:20. Start with the. Let's look at verse 3. Let's start 23. Jehoshaphat feared and set himself to seek the Lord and proclaimed a fast throughout all Judah. And Judah gathered themselves together to ask help of the Lord. Even out of all of the cities of Judah, they came to seek the Lord. Okay, so they were getting in a position to believe God by seeking the Lord, and in the process of seeking the Lord, they actually proclaimed the fast. Okay, now Jehoshaphat stood in the congregation of Judah and Jerusalem in the house of the Lord before the new court and said, O Lord God of our fathers, art thou not God in heaven, and rulest not thou over all the kingdoms of the heathen? And in thine hand is there not power and might, so that none is able to withstand thee? Art thou not our God, who didst drive out the inhabitants of this land before thy people Israel, and gavest it to the seed of Abraham, thy friend forever? And they dwell therein, and have built thee a sanctuary therein for thy name, saying, if when evil, verse 9, that is a direct quotation from prayer that Solomon prayed. This is what Solomon prayed. This was God's promise to Israel in general. If when evil cometh upon us as the sword, judgment, or pestilence, or famine, we stand before this house, and in thy presence, for thy name is in this house, and cry unto thee in our affliction, then thou wilt hear and help. So that was a promise that God made, and all he was saying is calling God to his what? Calling him into remembrance of his what? Promise. And that's the reason why we need to use the word of God whenever we are praying. So God, this is what you said over here. This is what you said. You said that if I would be walk before you with all of my heart, and I would obey you. You said that you're the faithful God who keepeth covenant with them that what? Fear you and walk before you with all of their heart. Lord, this is what you're saying. So you can pull up any promise or provision that God has made and use it in your particular what? Case. Anytime. That's the way we are trying to train you to what? Pray. Calling God to remembrance. And Sister Hill, I said, I ain't gonna do that. She said, well, you said this. You said you were gonna do it. Don't you think I'm gonna fix something? You know, it'll be a half a year. Most times she'll end up fixing it herself. No, she's better at fixing stuff. Brother Dan. But she said, you told me last week you were going to put that light bulb in. She'll always call me to what? Whenever she said that, then I said, oh gosh, I did say it. I had to try to keep my word now. So calling God to remembrance will always work. Okay, now. Okay.
So, okay, between you, humans and God, mm-hmm. You say call God to remembrance. It's not that he's human, we forget things. So why is it important for us to call God?
All right, that's a good question. Who wants to answer that? God doesn't, he knows what we have need of. He doesn't forget anything. Why is it that we need to remind him? That doesn't seem even necessary to me. Why is it important? All right, you said what's that? Yeah, right. He did say, but why God wants to be reminded when he knows everything?
That's for us to remember. Yes.
Huh? Us to him. So the way, you think it's necessary for us to remind God? He knows a lot more than me.
Not remind God, but who